video I watched today. It was about a guild on the Sorlona server that has a permadeath fight club. And what it is they have a challenge for all their guildmates, and they grab level 7 veteran characters, they go and run 2 quests, and each of the groups that make these level 7 vets have to run the same exact quest. They can start with nothing. Only thing they can use is what they find. No DDO store, no auction house. They can use vendors for pots and for wands, but only off of the money they get from the loot they sell from the 2 quests. And then they pick a tough quest, and they go into it, and the last man standing is the winner. This year, or whatever it was, every 6 months, every year, they did Temple of
the
Elemental Evil.
The vestibule of the temple is immense and they went in there empty.
And they made it about
then
15 minutes, I guess.
A tall figure ahead.
They were all
he
level
seems
7.
To be studying his surroundings.
It's crazy.
That's a good idea. I like that.
Yeah, it sounds like fun, doesn't it? Different way of doing it. And in the video, the guy posted the rules, you know, first rule of permadeath fight club, second rule of permadeath fight club, all that.
Is don't talk about fight club, right?
Exactly.
That was the very first time we had a big kind of ongoing thing that could last for months. When we did, like,
all right, cool.
Against the Giants
you
and all that stuff,
over here?
That would last for, like, 3 or 4 weeks, and then we'd be finished with the module. But Elemental Evil could go on, like, you could play it through an entire summer. And I think that's great. I think that this module's place in history is extremely important.
All right, Tef.
Because it represented a real sort of landmark turning point in what we expected from these games.
How many mushrooms is the first level?
200.
Oh, 200. Nice. There's Gray.
Where?
Come here, you little gem, you. You do not need to, no. If you like to, this guy's part of the story arc here, and the overgrown workbench here is part of the crafting that is specific to these 2 quests. Just to give kind of the same speech we had earlier, this is one of, if not the largest instances in DDO, the questing anyway, as opposed to, say, an explorer area. And we will not be exploring all of it. We will not be necessarily moving, you know, directly from point A to point B, but there are certain quest objectives we're going to have to complete, and they're not easy, so we're going to try to keep everybody alive and try to manage our resources. First things first, once you get done, I know you do. I just would like you to take a look at some of the optionals in your little XP bar when you expand it. You know, defeat 10 enemies in the temple, defeat, you know, 25, defeat 50, defeat 200, defeat 400. Yeah, it's rough.
Dungeon level 1.
All right, everybody click on the door to make it in. Taff, did you make it?
Guys just around the corner.
You see the blue dot where you shook me is standing?
Yes.
Alright. And these brazers are breakables. But weirdly enough, you really can only break them with...
I don't like that.
Yeah. I don't know what it is about. Alright, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 bandits. Looks like one of them saw me. That to a minimum.
Yeah. Uh-oh. I accidentally shot an orc.
Alright, we're going to hide behind this wall over here and drag them back to us. We don't want him to stop and go into bow stance and start picking us away. Our resources will not last if we do that too often, so we'll make him come to us and we'll gang mug him like a prison gang. Nice. Alright. We're going to step on forward. This guy will eventually become unfeared. Then we will kill him. Alright, we're not going to go any forward in this because we don't know what's around the corners. Yes, there are. And there's some humans over there. So. Bad guy coming in, temple guard.
Two more coming in.
Alright, there's 3 total. Just give him a second.
Hey.
2 more?
Oh, they hate. Yeah. They hate us.
There is a little hatred.
The master race, mate.
Stay behind me.
I got 2 coming back. Thought I had 2 coming back. Alright, there's 1 extra. He did not care about my bluffing, just for the record. Okay, let's talk about this next group. Have to be careful here. One's coming back already. Yep. Dead. Nice.
He did.
Also, this chest is running.
Say again?
I was just saying, when we first came in, there was a red name with the chest in that, but this time there's not. So
yeah. Yep. Isn't that kind of cool?
Yeah, I do like that.
Now, apparently, most of the... Apparently, most of the red names are in each instance. They're just not in the same spot. So, that's kind of cool. so you could find him if you were to hunt him all out.
Yeah.
Temple guard here. Looks like two. Got him coming back. Alright, he is by himself over there. He's bleeding down a little bit, though. Nice shot with the blood. Now, this one is a room for full of gargoyles. And I got two of them come back. One is a named gargoyle. He's Beleri. Gargoyles are dead. There's some statues over here which may or may not be gargoyles.
Something seems strange about this room.
Good to me, though. Does somebody want them? Nice.
Spot hidden over here. Opening the door.
Hey, Cap. Great, I take those key spots.
More hidden passage. And a handful of bad guys. Not just a small handful. We got some bad guys coming in. Got a bad guy coming in, or maybe a bad girl, bad thing, two things.
Oh.
bad guys coming in again. Shoot them, please. That was kind of weird. Did you see that?
No. What happened?
All right. When this guy went down, yes, exactly. He screamed, raise the alarm. And I wonder if that has something to do with any of the different kinds of aggro in this particular quest. And boom. Now there's four people in the hallway where there weren't a second ago. Now they're not aggro, but there are gas coming in. Alright, temple cultists. One's coming in. Gassed. Two temple cultists, one may or may not be a caster. Nice. Looks like a random chest to the west down the hall, but we'll want to clear this room where this sort of people ran in. Yeah, there's something in there. A white chanter. Let's see if I can bluff it. It's bluffed. Now it's angry. Two coming out. Good. All right. That room has got nothing in it that I was interested in seeing. Looks like a bunch of sarcophagi. There's a chest on this end, though. Alright, large empty room. No named, no anything else. Danger here.
I got the spot.
What do you think about that?
Anyone else
in that
target?
Ooh, leopards chill. Freezing Ice, Empty Purple Slot, Mythic Weapon Boost. That's nice. And who are we passing the mushrooms to? You get a Scorched Great Axe? Nice.
So what are the mushrooms for?
Upgrading the Scorched Great Axe that cost a Great Sword and the Leopard's Chill. Most of them can be upgraded. Mm-hmm. I don't know about the Leopard's Chill, actually, but usually it'll say it can be upgraded at Temple of Elemental Evil. Yeah, the Scorched Great Axe says right on there, upgradable item.
Yeah.
Yeah,
the Leopard's Chill isn't it? Since it's a consumable, I can basically collect them all, and then if anybody wants to upgrade something they've got, I can give it to them, right?
Sadly, no. You cannot consumables. The problem is mushrooms are not consumables. They're collectibles and craftables, and you can't pass those. You can't pass crafting gear. That's the deal. All right.
How many do you need to upgrade an item?
200. That's why I'm passing all mine to the same person. Hopefully, and I'm not saying we'll find enough. Maybe we will, maybe we won't. Yeah, if all six of us pass them all to one person, that person may have a chance. Maybe not.
Yeah. Well, who's gonna
there are two there? Quests. I think I've been passing mine to Taff, so just okay, however that works out.
If Vix picked up one of those weapons, it would make sense to give him to Vix because he's got something to upgrade.
Well, there you go.
Plus, I'm not a fighter. I'm a heal, but I'm not a fighter.
Okay, let you guys work it out. Who's their first time here?
Me. Me to a degree.
Okay. Come. Taff, if you want to come on over here and take a look at this door right here. Can you see what it says at the top? Earth Temple, right. Now, normally the rogue would open the door and do it from the side, but I'm going to stand back and I'm going to ask Vix to open the door. Vix, will you open that door for me? Say goodbye to Vix. See how the door does not open? It teleports you? All right, everybody come on through. You are very
this
trusting.
This enormous hall
yeah,
is
well,
much
we all came
wider
with him.
Than many
the
of the others
right
you've
him.
Seen in the temple. The sound of stone.
The first time
we
were roguing through here and the rogue got teleported, we're like, what the hell? It was very scary.
Unfortunately, at that time it teleported us in a room full of bad guys and it did not go well.
Yeah, it wasn't this room, it was a different place. We were all running around and going all sorts of crazy directions. Alright, let's have the party gather right about here. We're going to call this the kill zone. Because this is where likely one of you is going to die. And if you can see these red names running around out there. Yes, red name. Now take a look at them in your little viewfinder and please notice that they are a minimum of twice your level.
A belligerent cleric stands atop a stone altar in the center of this chamber. Four massive earth elementals patrol around the altar.
Okay. I have gotten one's attention.
One.
I'm hoping you're gonna kill it. Kill it! Shoot it! Kill it! What the hell? Jesus Christ, get him! I didn't bring him back here for you guys to dance with him. Kill him!
I was sort of stunned by a quickie was running.
He's a speedy one. Yeah, they're red names. They're immune to a lot of things. Pretty much everything I do.
Well,
they're just really excited.
Looks like we got his attention. Okay, kill him. Shoot him. Bite him. Get him. Damn it. Look, when I say kill, shoot, bite, you kill, shoot, bite. It's too late now. There's two of them. I gotta run backwards. Run, flee. Get scared. All right, kill him. Good news is there's only 12 of them left.
This is kind of the perfect energy quest, I think.
To go.
On the real week of the liar, you said four.
His elementals having failed, the cleric drops his magical wards to attack.
You pulling that guy?
Yeah, we're gonna have to kick care of that guy sooner or later too. You guys want to stay there and have me bring him to him? Yeah, you want to just kind of run down here and try to jump on him and hope that he doesn't crit you? Oh, too late. Here he is.
Roman, curate of the Earth Temple, falls silent.
Are we? Yeah. The good news is, if you were in here on Elite, you could have somebody cast a 20-point resist on you, maybe, and you wouldn't have to have nearly as much damage. Of course, imagine all the spell points they'd suck up trying to keep everybody hit with resist.
This great bronze door has had its wards removed recently, just like the door at the temple entrance.
Right, before we loot the chests, we're just going to come over here to the left and the right of this main room, just kind of look around. For no other reason than I just happen to think it's kind of a cool little area. This is the Earth Enclave, as it were. And if you go to the left and to the right, you can kind of see the little storage areas. Like, this is filled with wine casks and rock, like almost like they're like almost like this is where they birth an Earth Ellie. This might be like where an Earth Ellie is coming out of the ground to be made or something. It's kind of cool. On this little pedestal over here is the Earth Temple key acquired, so that took one of the objectives off of our bar, and here's a chest.
The Earth Temple key begins to quiver and shake. It seems strangely drawn to the south.
Alright, if everybody has their loot, time to scoot. Slow down here. I mean, you swear we just walked over here, and therefore the area should be clear, right? Welcome to Temple of Elemental Evil. You were just here, and it's still not clear. Here comes the bad guy. Which is why we're going to go all through the door together, so that way we won't be separated, and if there are bad guys, nobody ends up being teleported. 1, 2, 3, quickie. You don't want to go through the door and then find you the only one over there with 16 other bad guys or something. Alright, still clear? Bad guys, bad guys. And there's still two bad guys, just for the record. Two bad guys. One coming in. Clear to the shrine. Bad guys, bad guys, and bad guys. Here comes two of them. Yes, there are. Alright, there's a room to the west. It has a chance of a bonus chest, no guarantees. But even if we don't go in the room, I'd like you all to come up to right about where I'm standing and just take a look in the room. Maybe tab around a little bit. Yeah, they spawn a lot less on hard. there's a scary guy in here. It's a temple harpy. It's a CR9. And it's not necessarily scary just because it's a flying beast, but it's scary because its friend over here, ooh, which does have a chest, and I can see it from now, is crowned. And you can't even click on it. You have to get within range to aggro the son of a gun. Yep, one of them saw me.
What is he, like a gargoyle or
something? Something. Well, I don't know what.
Oh,
here we go. Nice. And a bonus chest on top of all that? Okay, bonus chest first. What the hell? Alright, we'll deal with the remnants. Everybody step forward, loot the chest, try not to aggro or anything else if we can avoid it. If we can't, holler out. Chest, come back down the hallway. Grab your remnants. Try not to shoot anybody while you're grabbing your remnants. What's that, Taff?
I was just asking Vix if that's any good for you. Yeah, I think it is, actually.
Hey Vix, do you guys have elevators over there in Australia?
I need one or two.
Gotcha, gotcha. Hey, what's that symbol over the door look like to you?
Going down?
Yeah, I really want
to. Alright.
That's what she said.
She wasn't that lucky. Alright. Now this door actually has the teleport sign on it, but there are some that don't, so that's why I kind of pull a little trick on Vix, but it's kind of fun. It can be scary. Let's all click on the door at the same time so we all go through. One, two, three. Off to the right we have, looks like, five temple guards, some clerics. Off to the left we have some temple guards, some clerics. They're all angry. There's one now, on the left-hand side. Be careful not to aggro too many at one time if we can help it. As we got one or two coming in, these are throwers. Let's just, yeah, fear them a little bit if we can once they get out of their range. Alright, so we got two left. One's not a crown and one is a crown. And I got nothing.
Just rush him, huh?
Alright, let's rush him there and kill him. Alright, well, while we're on this side, let's go this way. To the water temple. Now this door does not have the teleportation sign, but let's click on it all together anyway. 1, 2, 3, clicky.
The air in this room is almost uncomfortably cool.
Well, that looks like a crown gargoyle up there, if you ask me. That one's not crowned. Well, they don't look like they're active. Oh, there's a water altar over here. Oh, crap, they're active.
They're both active.
And bonus active. Nice work.
Thanks for the heads up, FX.
So I was just about all over you.
Sealed door.
Side of the screen.
Some sort of symbol of Cthulhu over here. Almost like an elephant with an eyeball. Maybe it's an East Indian god or goddess. And a water altar. I click on it, and it says, the shrine sits empty, walk away. You don't see the eyeball on it? Over here? Looks like an angry elephant. I like calamari. Alright. More water on the ground over here. What's this over here? It doesn't show that it's going to teleport you. Maybe one of you could click on it and see if it's safe.
That should be a rogue's job, right?
Alright, whoever clicked on it should come back over here and see if the water altar here is friendly to you.
As you fill the pool, the barrier disappears.
Pretty simple. You clicked on it and the water disappeared from over there. You clicked on it over here and here it is. Ta-da. Now, these guys don't look like they're too angry. This guy's got 223 hit points, though. Oh, look at that. Way in the back over there is a key. A key, I say. I got a brand new pair of roller skates.
Adherents of the Water Temple
key.
Pray softly in this small chamber.
All right.
A small piece of metal.
Who volunteers to come all the way in here?
At the back of
all
the
of
room.
You? Nice. All of you. Come on. Let's go. Good job. Now, who wants to stay as far back as possible so as not to get killed in case anything scary immediately happens right here in the center of the room? Just in case.
That would be me.
You know, don't want to be instantly killed. That would be bad. You can invis yourself if you want. Who has acid resistance that we want to pass out? Nobody? Alright, I feel bad for some of you. Yep, sure do. Okay.
The room begins to shake. And a shimmering wall appears at the entrance to the chamber.
paralyzed. Thank you for the heals. Well, we got the water elemental key. Isn't that nice? Mm-hmm. I'm not sure what the means. 1's 1, 0. All right. Well, we did find a shrine that we could run 3/4 of the way back across the quest to find, and then hope nothing spawns on the way there, and then find the way back. Yeah, it's rough. Okay. Tank, if you want to open this door, go right ahead, but do so from the side. I don't want you to get blasted. But it looks like the barrier's back up, and there's gems on either side. We have to get to light up to get the barrier down. So just don't open.
Something's aggroed on this door over here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That might not be a good idea to open that one. Let's open this one. There's nothing aggro over here. I'm opening it, running away. Alright, we have a cultist coming in. That would be a red-named water ellie, or at least a orangish name. So I'm going to guess that that means that it's immune to any kind of her fear effects. And probably could use a cold resist if you have it. I have my own 10-point cold resist.
Look at that, Gordon. Go too bad.
Nice. Yep. Alright. I went over to this other door, and as I walked up to the door, it hit me with freezing spray. There it is again. So anytime I get close to the door, I'm getting hit with freezing spray. There it is again. Maybe somebody else would be able to open the door. And that's two. That's two of the four rooms. We have an air temple key and a fire temple key. Yep, we have to go find the air and the fire key still. Isn't that nice? I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, yeah, that's kind of cool. All right, everybody to the door. Click on it and step outside. Hope we don't have 10 people respawn already. Alright, well, as before, we have a handful of bad guys over there. I will pull a couple back, and when they get away from their friends, you can shoot them. There you go, shoot that guy. Here comes another. Shoot him. Okay, if you guys want to step over to this door, please be on your very best behavior and be careful. Everybody step inside. 3, 2, 1, go. Anybody have fire resistance they'd want to pass out? Just check it.
This chamber is much warmer than the outside passage. Come in, follower of flame, a stern voice echoes. You're just in time.
Okay, what we're going to try to do is we're going to try to stay back here, and I'm going to try to bring the fight back here to kind of make it easier. But let's face it, you can't click on these guys, they don't seem to care. Now, if I end up with a mob, I will try to kite them around, and just do not panic. Try to heal me if I get within range, but don't have to come out for me. I don't have fire resistance, but I do have some healing pots, so I'm gonna go talk to this guy up here at the ladder and see what he says.
On the altar sits a small, cracked basin. Come, the cleric calls. Pay tribute to the fire. Your offerings have been rejected, the prefect booms.
And
so have you!
That looks bad.
That peel one of them off me if you get a chance. Don't panic about me too much.
The leader of the Fire Temple grows quiet and still. The barrier surrounding the Fire Temple key dissipates.
I've been stunned, now I need heals. I need heals.
By the fervor of its strongest
I'm good. Heroes. Stunned again. Well, aside from a curse, some horrible non-use of fire.
Okay.
Yep. Well, now we're down to the air key. So now we have tough decisions to make. I can tell you now the air key is not any easier than any of these. I don't imagine it's going to be the easiest key to get. Let's everybody step outside. same time. 3, 2, 1, click. If we try to go back to Shrine, we may or may not find bad guys along the way. We may or may not use up resources along the way and come back here and just be almost where we are now. If we push forward and we get the air key, I can't guarantee that that is going to get us to the next shrine either. I haven't even seen the next shrine.
The strong winds circulating this chamber suggest that this is, or was, the air temple.
You say you want to try to go back and get the other shrine? Go back to the first shrine?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I don't think that's the worst idea I've ever heard.
Because I'm getting kind of dangerously low on my big heels.
All right. This is back to dungeon level 1. 3, 2, 1, click. We should all stay together, we'll be fine. Vic, how many laying hands you got left?
Still got 4 left.
Oh,
left.
Nice. Alright, everybody come on up. Again, we're going to have to be careful for any kind of thing that may have spawned, including traps, so try not to get too crazy. Frankly, it all looks pretty clear. All right. Well, that doesn't look too bad.
Gonna be lucky sometime.
Yeah, I'll take a little luck. I got 6 blood tributes going. I'm happy to not be dead.
Can I AFK for 1 second?
Alright. Yeah, feel free to expand your map and see the places we have covered, and just see how many places still have openings, like there may or may not be more areas to cover still. The place is pretty damn big. Alright, so everybody is back. Let's step over, back away from the shrine a little bit, just so we can make sure everybody's away, back from AFK, Farium, Taff. Yeah, I thought Taff might still be gone, so he's always very quiet. Alright, let's head on back to where we came out. To the south! That was pretty effortless, I thought. That was nice. Alright, when you get to the door, somebody click on the door. Alright, straight across from us looks like another up button. Straight down from us, there looks like a whirlwind, then out in the middle towards the center a little bit, it's a broken pillar, and between us and that pillar, looks like there's a protective orb. Let's go around for a minute. Well, I'd say this looks like the air elemental chamber, if you ask me. Gray, you gonna be okay? Let's jog back over to where Gray is and make sure that he's not managed to come full side here. Looks like he may be stuck in a loading screen.
I was just going to say, I've got 5 pots of resist electricity if anybody needs one.
I've got 2 and 1 of cold. I also have a fire shield and a cold shield. But I'd be saving them. There'd be some other places I may wish to find a use for them.
Yep, that was always going to happen.
All right, let's do a little exploring. If you guys will come this direction, to the north. If Gray Jam logs back on. Alright, do not click on this door. Do not click on the door. But come over here and take a look at the door and read what it says. Yeah, the Hall of Triumphal Evil. So someday you get on a non-permadeath character and you happen to be level 10 or so and you decide, I'm just going to come and explore the rest of the place in here. You tell me what happens when you go in there, okay?
Sounds like you're speaking from experience, mate.
There he is.
There he is.
All right, we're all grouped back up again. Fresh as daisies. I'm sorry, Vix. I said I would never call you that in front of other people, but I slipped.
I don't mind. Pet names are okay.
All right, we're going to go through this door here to the Western Halls, the Air Temple Quarters. 3, 2, 1, Licky. And look at that. It's a bad guy right there. What are you doing over there? Nothing. What are you doing? Nothing. Hey, look at that. He's decided to come in to see.
This area of the temple once housed those faithful to the Air Temple.
All right, I'm going to clear the north
now,
side if there's anybody.
The Air Temple is in disarray.
There's
and
not.
Orcs have taken over these quarters.
For those of you with a curious mind who want to come take a look at this door down here, don't click on it, please. Just take a look.
If there's evil in there, we should go in there.
Well, if you mean we, as you and your shield, go ahead. All right, one or more bad guys coming back. I got the bug bane damage. Here's another orb for your Wheaton.
As I grew up, and as I was a weird, cerebral, withdrawn, awkward, shy kid, I could always go into Dungeons and Dragons where I was awesome.
All right.
I was either a really powerful wizard, or I was a really sneaky thief, or I was the dungeon master, like keeping this world alive. It was a place where the stuff that made me weird and uncomfortable on the playground in real life, it made me valuable and important and special. And that all started by myself. Kind of going through like choose your own adventure style with that simple dungeon crawl. And everything that I ever did since then sort of sprang from that experience.
Alright, crown's coming in. Let's back up a little ways. Looks like there's three of them. Looks like they're non-aggroed at the moment. Sentry. Another sentry. And another sentry. Alright, well, they're aggroing now. Yeah, looks like it might be from the other room. I'll throw a search out here just to double check. And it gets even worse. Apparently I cannot search it there. Oh, thank you. Yep, there's several panels in the other room apparently. Okay, on your best guard here. Open the door. All right, let's just hold up a second here. That is Kelno the Prefect, and he is the Prefect of the Air Temple. Weirdly enough, he has a ruin back there. So let's go see what Kelno has to say. He's got 1,477 hit points. He's a CR-12. He appears to be a bearded old man. He's probably a sissy. You know what? He might even be our friend. I can't even think of a reason why we'd fight him. One of his buffs, if you examine him, is brittle skin. Not only is he blurry, but if he hits you, he can give you -2 to your PRR, and every time he hits you, it stacks up to 10,000 times. Are you ready?
A man in air temple robes stands huddled in the corner of this cold, dark room.
Back out of the room, fight the methods on our own terms. Keep backing up.
I'm stunned.
Count us down to 800. I think I got his aggro.
Of the air temple falls to the ground. You search him carefully, but you don't find the air temple key on his person.
All right.
On the wall above this rune is a small etching in the shape of a key.
You don't have to use it if you don't want to, but come take a look at it. Says the ruin has a small etching of a key. Alright, I use the rune.
So I'm assuming that's up the bubble that was around the key in the other room then.
Alright, let's step outside. Nice and easy. 3, 2, 1, go. Now, from our previous location, there were still these wind jets, these air tunnel-looking things, these almost wind elemental-looking things right here. And the pillars are fallen, but now there's that bubble down there is gone. Let's go down and take a look at it. Oh, wow, that's kind of cool.
The Air Temple key sits behind a barrier on the altar. A note next to it reads, "To be used with Kelno's express permission only. No exceptions."
All right. Well, this may or may not turn into some sort of a fight. I don't know. I don't expect any traps around it. You guys that do range damage may want to back up or go up top again, or I don't know, maybe you get locked out if you go up there. Somebody want to volunteer to grab that key?
You?
All right, I'm going to grab the key. 3, 2, 1. Ready?
The winds circling the room rush faster as the key is taken from the altar.
He was a big bastard. He's a big bugger, ain't he? Guess that's the guardian of the air temple, in case you haven't met him before. For some reason, he never has a chest. I don't know what his issues are.
Yeah, he's not worldly.
All right. Shall we rise to the occasion?
Mm-hmm.
Now, for those of you that have noticed, there hasn't been another shrine. None of the earth, air, fire, or water enclaves have had shrines.
Let's go find Aaron.
All right, let's go see where he might be. Let's check the downstairs. To the southern halls and dungeon level 3. Everybody in. Alright, is everybody in? Little head count? He said little. It's a halfling joke. Okay. That looks like an owl there. Sweet beak, CR11, magical beast, owl bear, loves halflings. Oh. Anybody want to volunteer to go pet Sweet Beak? Oh, his name is Sword Beak. I'm mistaken. I'm sorry. Let's go. Now Sweet Beak is a rug. Anybody want to volunteer to go search Sweet Beak's cage over here with the green goo? Because frankly, it looks horrible. Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I count 11. 11 bad guys. Two more coming in.
There's lots more to the left.
Yeah, they're throwing something at us, that's for sure. There's a handful of them over there. You want to go left? You want to just ignore them for now and keep going?
To the right.
Alright. Let's push forward then. Oh, look, another door with the down button above it. Nice. Well, here's the door with the down button. Let's everybody click it. 3, 2, 1, quickie. Alright, that's not a good sign, generally speaking. The bad guys start puffing behind the door. Let's move away from that door. Everybody forward. Here's another down button. 3, 2, 1, clicky.
This place is huge.
All right. You know, you've noticed we've skipped a couple of floors along the way for the sake of expediency. There's a lot to do in here. But the truth is that shrines are scarce. All right. And here's where trouble begins. If you right-click on that glowing slash cloudy mushroom ahead of you, you can see what it really is. It's a toxic mushroom. It is a red or slash orange name. It's a CR9. It's a plant creature. It's a bad guy. And it's not kidding.
Is that mushroom poison?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. There's a cleansing one behind it. That is true. I think we can kill the toxic one from here if we get some ranged on it. I don't know if it will aggro other mushrooms around it or if it will, you know, just come running at us by itself. But I say we shoot it and find out. Vix, you want to you wanna come to the bottom of the stairs and tank it?
It's almost dead.
Good job, Vix. You tanked a mushroom.
You brought me along for something.
Hey, if nothing else, we needed to have a little comic relief. Okay, I'm going to ask everybody to back up just a little bit except for Vix. Vix, I want you to take about 2 steps forward, but don't touch the grass. Don't touch anything. Just stay there for a second. Okay, run back here. Run back. Back up.
He's going to need healing.
He needs healing, yeah. He needs healing. Faster, yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. That is just the area of effect damage for being in there. And it compounds. Yes, I would assume so as well. Now, whether you have to run over to the cleansing mushroom and click it, bite it, eat it, use it, sleep with it, jump on top of it, hide behind it, all of that is completely, yep. So,
I mean, if you sleep with it and bite it, does that count as a twofer?
Say again, Pat?
I said if you sleep with it and bite it, does that count as a twofer?
Yes, it does.
Yeah, it was. Was that some damage?
I think you should look at your combat log and double check that, just to be on the safe side.
Looking from here, there's a sheltering mushroom and a cleansing mushroom.
I thought it was bludgeoning damage. Toxic mushroom. And that's all sorts.
All right. Who here has some version of Expeditious Retreat or otherwise haste pot, something like that?
Yeah, I've got a haste pot.
All right. Now, who else? Who also has some sort of elixir of healing, aid, something like that? All right. You guys got something covered? Okay. Gray, you got something for healing or aid or something as well?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I will go first. I will go check out the cleansing mushroom, and just wait for me here. I will holler. Just wait for me here. I'll go my own.
Thank you.
All right. Oh, there's another cleansing mushroom off to the left. Click on it. When you click on it, it removes all those stacks that are on you. All right, I managed to make it all the way through. Oh crap! And apparently, I only took 1 point of damage from it, but that was still a lot. All right, come through to me. All the way through. Yeah. Oh, unless you got more stacks or something. Yep. Remember, the sheltering mushroom is not enough. You look like you made it. All right, good. So as you run through, if you click on the shelter or on the cleansing mushroom, it removes the stacks of bad things happening to you.
Okay, with
yep, don't get too close to it, Vix. It'll stack on you again if you get too close, Vix. Yep, Vix is going to try to hit you with lay on hands if it gets too dangerous when you come through here. But just try to run as fast as you can to where Vix is standing.
Who's coming through next?
I'll come through.
You don't want to get too close to the edge and just stand there. You either run through it or you don't go anywhere near it. Because even just area of effects, right? As you run through, you need to click on the cleansing mushroom. Click it to remove any stacks of bane damage as you come through. When I clicked on it, it removed all the damaging effects. But you still have to keep running. Yes, it's to the left. The kind of purplish ones are... Yep, exactly. No, to... Yeah, left. You're coming out and to the left where Vix is. North and west. I don't know if that's the case. I don't think that's the case at all. Yeah, click on this. There you go. All right, you got 5 seconds left still. 3, 2, 1. Okay, looks like you're all right. Good deal. All right, who's next?
Nexarium.
All right, come ahead. Yeah, I count 7 seconds left. I didn't see you ever click on the cleansing mushroom. That looks like you're all right. Gray, you're up, sir.
Okie doke.
And if you just click directly on the sheltering mushroom, it removes all the stacks that are currently on you, but apparently it continues stacking up. All right, you got 8 seconds left on you as well. You're going to at least a little further from the outer edge, just to be on the safe side.
Yay.
All right, nobody died there. That's nice. As Vix found out, each stack actually doubles the damage it does to you. So it's crazy. Doesn't take too many stacks before you're just plain dead. Alright, looks like an opening. Hey, there's a shrine, some gargoyles, and some braziers. Danger! Holy cow, I spotted the danger. All right, looks like that all's all down there. Bad guys. A few more bad guys, some of them are archers.
My favorite class is the classic AD&D wizard class, which is weird because you would expect that a weird, awkward, shy, uncoordinated, nerdy kid like me would have wanted to be a fighter or a barbarian or someone powerful or someone unlike me. And I wanted to be a wizard because wizards needed to be smart, right? Intelligence was a really important part of being a wizard. And intelligence mattered to me in real life. And I liked imagining that I could go into a place where I look like this frail, little kind of like Raistlin kind of guy. And some big, cool kid comes in and messes with me, and I'm like,
everybody click on this door. I cast a spell,
and now you're encased in ice, and I'm leaving, and you suck, and I win. I win because my mind
is better than yours. We opened all the portals. We are now on Find Fowler Chamber and determine his plan, find the spider eggs for the frog keeper and all that. So now we decide if we want to go forward into what is likely to be the facing of Falrent.
Spicy.
All right. If you can stand right where I'm standing and not much further, not, you know, don't get too far ahead of me, you can see that there's water to the left, pile of rocks to the right, a little further up ahead on the right is lava, and there's nothing but air to the further ahead on the left. So, kind of get what the picture they're painting here is.
Get dirty in the rocks, wash in the water.
No, I can't really have the rest.
Get dirty in the rocks and wash in the water. Alright. So, if you have any buffs you'd like to put on yourself, this is the time to do it. Alright, come forward up to here. Alright. I'm gonna go inside a little further. Everybody wanna come up inside? Everybody can. Entrez vous, s'il vous plaît. Everybody up? Okay. If we do end up getting into some sort of a mass combat here, what we're going to want to do is determine who's going to take aggro. So I would like those who would want to take aggro first, people like Vix, people like you, Shookme, just to jump forward and get the aggro first rather than to... But we need to call out who we're fighting, what we're fighting, where we're going. I don't want to have 10 of us fighting 10 different things. I want to be able to kill one thing, put it down, and move to the next thing. All right. I will go forward.
I'll be right behind you.
That's all I can ask. Buffing the criminal out of myself. Here we go.
The wizard Falrent floats high above this chamber. I know why you have come, his voice, but you're too late. Using the arcane power of the page I discovered, Zuggetmoy is nearly free.
Alright, I want to fight the air ellie first. Jeff!
What happened, bro?
Hey! Vix, pull the air ellie back to us. Pull the air ellie away from the air. Yeah. Yo, now kill it. Me either. Air ellie's dead. Water ellie next. Okay, fire Ellie next. Air Ellie's at home. The water Ellie is on her home base, so she's hard to hurt.
Yeah, let's kill the fire. Oops, I need heal, Oh, man. I'm stunned. Ow. trouble.
I'm dead.
Fire alley's down.
Kill the rock.
Let's pull them. Let's pull them both back. Let's pull them both out of the water so they're weaker. Ethereum, can you heal yourself?
Where's Fernum?
I'm on the earth alley. I'm in the air corner. Watch out for cold damage.
We're just getting started. Creech, take care of them.
I'm gone.
With his butt.
Fine.
I'm against that.
Spits. I'll just have to crush you myself.
Well, you know you got it. There you go.
I'll get the time to get out.
You can probably click on the shield over there and get out.
You might be able to click on the exit that is to the south and escape. I don't know if you can or not. Not a bad
he's
idea
out.
To try it.
He's out. Yeah, he's out. He made it out. Good job, sir. At least you got out. I'm going to release, guys.
That's
yeah.
Crazy. Awesome, though. I loved it. That was fantastic.
Yeah, I'd like to get all the ones too. That was worth dying for. Oh, guys, I gotta run. That was good fun. Thanks very much.
Glad you had a good time.
That was
see you later, guys.
I take care. Oh man, that's too bad too. That is such a tough infight.
That is crazy. I mean, going through it's like, oh, okay, you know, this is actually kind of almost too.
And the first few times through, we had parties wipe along the way because the doors, you know, you stay too close to the rogue or you click on a door and you teleport. You got to remember that because the mobs and the traps are random, when you land, when you teleport, you can be in a nest of traps or in a nest of mobs. It's, you know, do we just have not to find any that particular time?
Yeah, I much prefer the whole randomization because it keeps you on your toes because you can't metagame it, and I love that.
Yeah, that's for sure. It's crazy.
Yeah, that was awesome. I really enjoyed that. even though I was the blue guy. That was a lot of fun. That was the most fun quest I've done in quite a while.
You know, and I want to tell you that those bad guys are so tough, and if you don't lead them around until they're outside of their own area, they just stay super tough. But I mean, how much can you really say without just blowing the whole thing? First couple times we went in there, we just died outright.
Oh, well, I think it's because, well, it was my first time. I mean, I played this game for years, and that was my first time in that class. And I think that really helped. That was awesome. I really enjoyed that. It just was something.
Well, good. I'm glad you enjoyed it. You know, and I think that with all the things that are going on in the forum today, if more people were to go on there and post that they still enjoy the guild, you know, they don't have to say what it, you know, that they like playing only with this person and not with that person, only like playing this style and not that style. Just say, hey, are you still having fun? I think sometimes people miss out on that.
They get too tangled up in all the politics and bullshit. It's supposed to be enjoyed.
That's right. It's supposed to be a good time.
Yep. All right, folks. It's not been my ears on the ski battle as well. But thank you very much for the run. That was an absolute blast. So I'll catch you guys tomorrow.
All right. Well, I'm glad you had a good time.
Oh, I did, mate. Have a good night, though.
All right, now. The official heirloom item.